Chapter number 5, Indigo. I have already told you everything about the author Louis Fisher. So now let us start with the reading of the chapter. When I first visited Gandhi in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram in central India, he said, "I will tell you how it happened." Louis Fisher had met Mahatma Gandhi first time in 1942, that too in his ashram, in Mahatma Gandhi's ashram in Sevagram, which is in central India. Then he said, "I will tell you how it happened. What was the reason, I will let you know in detail. I decided to urge the departure of the British. That there I decided to request him that the Britishers should leave India. It was in 1917. In the beginning, he had gone to December 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow. Mahatma Gandhi has gone to Lucknow in 1916. Why? To attend an annual convention of Indian National Congress. During the proceeding, when the convention was going on, the procedure was going on, Gandhi recounted. Now Gandhiji is telling, when everything was going on normally, all of a sudden what happened? A peasant came to me looking like any other peasant in India. A very simple man, a peasant, you can say a farmer, came to Mahatma Gandhi. He was looking like any other farmer, and what he said, "I am Rajkumar Shukla, I am from Champaran, and I want you to come to my district." You know Champaran, have you heard about Bihar? It is somewhere near the foothills of towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. If you just see the map, you find out where Nepal is and where the Himalayas, the towering Himalayas are. In the foothills, down under that, there is the state Bihar. And in Bihar, there is Champaran. Under an ancient agreement, just read it very carefully, what was the problem for which Rajkumar Shukla has come to take Mahatma Gandhi to Champaran? There was an agreement. The Champaran peasants were sharecropper. Now, what do you mean by sharecropper? Those who share the cropping, you will say in a very simple way, I'll explain it. Rajkumar Shukla was one of them. He was illiterate. Obviously, he hadn't gone to school. He was illiterate, but resolute. Resolute is the one who is firm in his decisions. He had come to Congress session to complain. What for? What was the complaint about? The injustice of the landlord system in Bihar. Landlord system was having unjust practice in Bihar. And somebody had probably said, speak to Mahatma Gandhi. Somebody informed Rajkumar Shukla that regarding this injustice, we should go to talk Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi told Shukla he had an appointment in Kanpur. Kanpur, which you nowadays call Kanpur, and was also committed to go to other parts of India. And he has so many programs to go to other parts of India somewhere. Shukla accompanied him everywhere. I told you he is determinant. He is resolute. So wherever Mahatma Gandhi went, Shukla followed him everywhere. Then Gandhi returned to his ashram near Ahmedabad. Shukla followed him to the ashram also. For weeks, he never left Gandhi's side. Gandhi's side, that means he never left Gandhi alone for a minute. He was not ready to leave without Mahatma Gandhi. He was just asking, fix a date. He begged, he requested very politely, just fix a date. Impressed by the sharecropper's tenacity, the problem, the seriousness of the issue, when Mahatma Gandhi sensed it, guessed it, and story, Gandhi said, "I have to be in Calcutta on such and such date." He told Rajkumar Shukla that on these days, I'll be there in Calcutta. Come and meet me and take me from there. You can come there and take me from Calcutta. Months passed. Many days passed. Shukla was sitting on his hunches. Hunches means when you sit on your legs. on the floor at the appointed spot. The spot, the place which was decided in Calcutta when Gandhi arrived, he waited till Gandhi was free. He was not so eager that when Gandhi ji came, he went there and asked him to accompany me to Bihar. No, he waited that Gandhi is to complete or finish his urgent work. Then the two of them, that means Mahatma Gandhi and Rajkumar Shukla, boarded a train for city of Patna in Bihar. They took a train. There Shukla led him to the house of lawyer named Rajendra Prasad. Rajendra Prasad was a lawyer, which you can say vakil. And you know, Rajendra Prasad is the same man who became the first president of independent India, who later became president of Congress Party and of India. Rajendra Prasad was out of town. He was not at home at that time when Shukla and Gandhiji came, but the servants knew Shukla. Those who were there in the house, the servants, they knew Rajkumar Shukla because he has come here so many times to trouble Rajendra Prasad because he was a lawyer regarding this sharecropping problem. As a poor yeoman, a poor farmer who pestered means bother, disturb karna their master. Master here stands for Rajendra Prasad, to help the indigo sharecropper for the same problem. So they let him stay on the grounds with his companion. Companion here means Mahatma Gandhi. So he asked Rajkumar Shukla to stay outside on the ground and wait. Gandhiji, whom they took to be another peasant, they thought that the person with him is also a simple farmer who was Mahatma Gandhi. But Gandhi was not permitted to draw water from the well. Why? Because at that time untouchability was prevailing, and they thought that Mahatma Gandhi is also an untouchable. He was not allowed to get water from the well, lest so that some drops from his bucket pollute the entire source. If some drops fell from his bucket, then the well will be polluted. How did they know that he was not an untouchable? Because so far Mahatma Gandhi was there in South Africa. He was practicing as a lawyer there. So they don't know that Mahatma Gandhi is a lawyer or who he was. Gandhi decided to go to first to Muzaffarpur. He decided that I'll go to Muzaffarpur, which was en route to Champaran. It was on the way to Champaran. What for? To obtain more complete information about conditions than Shukla was capable of imparting. Capable means he was able to impart, means to give. So he thought, I should get a detail of the seriousness of the issue, because I don't think Rajkumar Shukla is so much literate, so much educated. He can't give me this much detail. He accordingly sent a telegram to the professor J.B. Kriplani. You have to remember this name, of the Arts College of Muzaffarpur, because he was going to Muzaffarpur, whom he had seen at Tagore Shanti Niketan school. He had met Kriplani at Tagore Shanti Niketan, so he knew him. He sent a telegram to J.P. Kriplani that I am coming there. The train arrived at midnight. When he reached Muzaffarpur, it was midnight almost. So 15th April 1917, Kriplani was waiting at the station with a large body of students. So many, you can say, in large number, 100, 1000, 10,000, so many students were there. Gandhi stayed there for 2 days in the home of Professor Milkani, a teacher in a government school. It was very difficult. Something extraordinary. Why? I explain. It was the time of the British rule, and the one who is working under Britishers, that means the school teacher, is the employee of the Britishers. And how he can harbor, he can give shelter, he can allow Gandhiji to live at his home. It was something extraordinary. It was extraordinary thing in those days. Why in those days? Because India was under the rules of Britishers. Gandhi commented, for a government professor to harbor means to give shelter, to allow to stay at their home, a man like me means like Mahatma Gandhi, who was against Britishers, who was called there to let the Britishers go out of India. In smaller localities, the Indians were afraid. In small areas, people were very afraid to show sympathy. They can't show any concern for the advocates, because he was a lawyer also of Home Rule, those who were fighting for India.